We've talked a lot about the technology behind a lot of the options that are available in Azure SQL. When it comes to deciding what's best for your organizations, there are a few things you're going to want to consider. First, you're going to want to think about your backup strategy. Do you need long-term backups? And if you need them, how long do you need them for? When you think about your availability from an SLA perspective, what's going to be required for your database and your application? And is that going to meet the RTO and RPO needs that you have in the current service tier or configuration that you have? You're also going to want to think about, do you need read replicas? We've talked about several ways where you can get read replicas, whether it's in the business critical tier, you get one secondary that you can leverage as a readable, or if it's hyperscale, you can get 1, 0 to 4 secondaries that you can read. And with things like GeoDR, so that means maybe you have geo replication or you have auto failover groups, you can get even more readable secondaries available to you. So you need to think about, do you need these? In addition, you might want to consider if you want a zone redundant configuration with availability zones. And so these are just a few of the choices that are going to be required for you to think about for any given database and application. Now, Bob, you've worked a lot with SQL Server and applications and Azure SQL Database. Do you have any advice or insights on how people can make sure or decide if their application is ready?
Yeah, and if you think about all these choices and discussion, things you've talked about for customers to do, it's right to consider all the configuration choices, but everybody forgets about the app. And number one mistake I've seen customers make when they move to the cloud is ensure that their applications can do simple things like retry or have proper stateful logic. So even just considering how I should do retry logic and reconnect myself, even if it's using one of the options you've talked about, is really, really important. So if you're a SQL Server expert and you're looking at Azure SQL as an option, make sure you're working very closely with your development team and study how they do retry logic, in their application.
Thanks. Yeah. And so in this video, we kind of talked about the different options you have to make and the different decisions you'll have to make and conversations you're going to want to have with your larger organization. See you in the next video.